Welcome back, guys. So today I'm going to be highlighting another awesome NES game that I highly recommend playing, and that game is Gapless. So Gapless is a very recent release, an official release from Bandai Namco, and it's fully playable on original hardware, on an NES, via flashcards or emulation if you so choose, or Mr. FPGA. This is pretty cool. So it was ripped from the Namco Museum Archives Volume 2, which I do highly recommend checking out. I've bought both volumes. They're $20 each. This game was ripped from the PC version of Volume 2. Volume 2, it has a handful of titles, some really cool stuff, but the biggest one was Gapless being included. It's an 8-bit consoleized version of the original arcade game. So back in 1984, Gapless was released in Japan, and it was a sequel to Galaga. Galaga is one of my all-time favorite arcade games. One of the first arcade games I remember playing. Came out back in 1981. I still play it all the time to this day. Later on, there was a modification kit released in the US where they changed Gapless to Galaga 3, which doesn't make any damn sense because there was no Galaga 2. Like, you have to remember, Galaga 88 came out in 87. So if that was Galaga 2... it like came from the future. I don't know. It doesn't make any damn sense. But for whatever reason, they said Galaga 3. We're doing it, right? So in this game on the NES, I've been really addicted to it. I never really played the arcade game too much. I think it just like flew past me for some odd reason. But playing it on the NES, it's really cool. Very faithful, other than the original is a vertical, you know, orientation. And I did notice some things with that, like doing the bonus stages. I don't know, maybe I'm just shooting the enemies incorrectly, but you're supposed to bounce them around in order to spell out words, and there's different words depending on whichever bonus stage you're in. I can't accomplish it, so I don't know, but in the arcade with the vertical orientation, you could see where the enemies bounce to and you could line up your shots. Whereas on this one, you lose sight of where the enemies are as they go past the screen. So I don't know. It's kind of strange, but I don't even care about the bonus stages. I know a lot of people play these games for scores, and that's one of the things. Maybe I just got to figure it out. But the really cool thing with this game is it's Galaga on crack, essentially. Like, the way everything plays, the enemies do change as well over, I believe after, like, the 10th stage, the enemies will change sprites, and I thought that was really neat. But one of the cool things is the extra weapons you can get. There's like a tractor beam, one of the first weapons you'll get, which, is it a weapon? I guess it is, but you could suck up enemies. Essentially, you're taking over enemy ships, lining them up, and then just blasting your way through the stages. There's also like a phase beam where you can suck up the enemies and then shoot them. There's another weapon that turns them all to stars where they can't hurt you. There's another one where it slows everything down. But I really think the addition of those weapons is really cool. And you know, it gets really hectic. Even when you have, like, a lineup of enemy ships on your side, like, four or five ships total, and you're just blasting through, it could still get a little crazy because of the way the formations are, how the ships are coming down at you. But definitely, if you're just solo, it's nuts trying to get through. Even getting the boss ship that you can get the weapon from can be pretty tough because that fool leaves. Like, I think after two cycles, he just bounces. He's gone. And you can no longer get that weapon from him. So you have to act quick. And if he's going down with a swarm of other enemies, I mean, you're almost going to miss out on it. But I've been having a blast with this game. It is a ton of fun. It's out there. You could play it on the NES, like I said. But it's also, you know, it came from this collection, Namco Museum Archives Volume 2. Highly recommend checking that out. But just wanted to give you guys the heads up. This is playable on original hardware. And I find that really awesome when we get games that could be played on the original hardware and they're new. Like, this is some awesome stuff here. An official release as well. It's unheard of. And I think it's kind of crazy with these collections being put out. And these companies actually designing these games with the original hardware in mind, instead of just making a whole new game that just like plays on its own engine, they're making it to play via the NES emulator that they're including on that software in order to play the other games, right? So I think that's really cool that they're doing this kind of stuff. just wanted to give you guys a heads up on this game, Gapless. A lot of freaking fun. Been having a blast with this. Been having a blast with the Pac-Man Championship Edition on the NES. There's just so much stuff out there. So, hey, really do appreciate you guys hanging out with me. Hit that like button, subscribe, drop a comment down below. All those things help me out greatly, and it's really appreciated. We're on our way to 100,000 subscribers. So I just need your help. You know what I'm saying? But hey, I will catch you guys next time. Peace out, bye-bye, and boom. Bye.